Hi my beautiful friends, and how are we? Today you know what I'm going to share? A drape that you all have been always requesting me to do, a complete from the scratch to the finish tutorial on how to drape a Kanjivaram sari perfectly. I've been wanting to do this for so long, but then you know, but I'm giving it to you now. So a Kanjivaram sari is such a beautiful sari, but if you don't drape it properly, trust me, it looks like a whole mess around. So I feel you should know how to start, where to tuck, how much to pleat, where to pin, and all those details. So in this tutorial, all your problems related Kanjivaram sari drape will be solved, and I know you're going to wear a lot of Kanjivarams. I just feel, you know, investing on a good Kanjivaram sari is very, very sensible act, because it's the only thing, I mean, sari is the only thing, and then in sari a Kanjivaram which you can pass it on to generation. I'm also going to do a tutorial on how to keep your Kanjivaram sari, so stay tuned and let's do the drape now. Let's start. Okay, so this is a beautiful Kanjivaram sari, and what I'm wearing it with is a decote. It's fine if I'm not wearing a matching color because it's not see-through, and also I cannot do without a decote. I cannot wear it on those flared petticoats, because when you wear that, any which ways Kanjivaram fabric goes a lot inside, and if your petticoat is not correct, you will have a lot of bulge here which you will not be able to correct, and you will just feel too bulky on this area. I mean, you know, so I just feel you bought a beautiful Kanjivaram, invest in a sensible decote, and then you will be able to see the difference. Okay, let me start with the drape. I'm just taking a handful of fabric and tucking this here. First I'm going to make my shoulder pleats, and when you're doing a shoulder pleats in Kanjivaram, try and make narrow pleats, because you know, it looks very beautiful here when you have 6-7 pleats. So I'm just going to make narrow pleats, and to align them, the best part, just take this here and, you know, just align them like this. And you can also use pegs and align them, you know, like this. And after you've done all that, attach a pin. And to make it even more neater, put it on this shoulder, and look what I do is I bring all my pleats in front and I do this and I spread this a little and just run my hand through this. Okay, I don't like using too much of ironing, you know, because it just makes the sari to look too flat. Okay, after you've done this, just rest this on your shoulders. Okay, so far you all have got it right, I think. So from here, take this like this, and attach a pin here, like this. Not too low, not too high, right here, okay? Now after you've attached a pin here, now in Kanjivaram, you see, you get those pleats here. You don't know the exact way to make it. Someone makes it after pleating, some make it before pleating. They don't get this right. The correct way to do it, I mean, you might have a different way to do it, but I feel very comfortable in doing it this way, and that is what I'm sharing with you, is you've attached a pin here. Now take this and, you know, like this, and tuck this in here. Okay, take another one, very beautifully shaping your waist, tuck this, take another one. You can have 4 to 5 pleats. I've done the third one and another one, and this goes my fourth one. See, you just have to have some patience and do it nice and neat. See this, okay? And you tuck this in here. After you've done that, then you're going to make your lower pleats, okay? So I'm just putting this in my hand here because it's going to be easy for me to pleat, And now I'm going to pleat the sari, seeing that my first pleat is falling straight. And it's very easy, you know, you can rest it in your arms and make your pleats. It's very, very easy to do it. This, and I've got this. Just dust all your pleats. You can lift them up and do it nice and neat. This, okay? After you've done that, just bring all your pleats together. And you must be feeling this has become loose, but don't worry, I'm going to show you. It's going to become tight again. See this? Lift all your pleats and tuck the whole thing inside. And now, when you're going to pick this up, look at this. The first pleat we did, the second, the third. Just going to align them with it. Can you see it? Look at this. Nice and tight, and you can rest the whole pleat on your shoulders back again. And yes, look at this. You've got all your pleats here in place and look so beautiful like this. So here it is, the complete drape. You can see how beautifully the pleats are falling. You should keep your palla long so that you don't have too many pleats here. I've just made 4 pleats. And then this side, because the Kanjivaram has bigger width than the normal sarees, so then it's, you know, what you need to do is adjust it with these pleats. Look, I've made 4 pleats here. You can see 1, 2, 3, and 4. And all coming from one line here. Looks very nice and neat. And I've used 1 pin here, 1 pin to secure the pleats, that's 2. 1 on the shoulder, that's 3 pins in total. I've seen a lot of people wearing Kanjivaram with a dozen pins. You don't need to use so many pins because it's such a beautiful, delicate fabric. I mean, making holes in Kanjivaram is so painful. So I would suggest you to just do these. And if you need another extra pin, I think 4. 4 is max that you should be using. So I hope this drape of mine was helpful to you. And I hope you're going to wear more of Kanjivaram sarees. I love these. I love this fabric myself. And definitely you're going to try them. Post a picture to me. And then if you're getting stuck anywhere, you can always message me, mail me, DM me. There's so many ways to connect with me. And I wish you all the very luck. And stay safe, stay blessed. I love you all. Jai Hind. Vanakkam.